A very special guest makes an appearance in Central Illinois today. It happened at Jacksonville's Illinois College, and that's where we find WAND's Ed Cross. He joins us now. Ed, it's not every day that a former U.S. president joins us here in Central Illinois.
Yeah, certainly not, Marianne. And it was a packed house here at Sherman Gymnasium, from students to faculty and community members coming out. And for some students, Jimmy Carter's past efforts still carry weight today. A full house for an honored guest. The 39th president, Jimmy Carter, spoke of pathways to peace before students and community members Tuesday.
When I left the White House, as my wife points out, involuntarily retired by the 1980 election.
While Carter used humor at times to make light of his time in office, much of his speech dealt with past and current tensions in the Middle East, encouraging younger generations to think about U.S. relations to foreign countries.
If I ask the average student in the class, or even the average adult, what are the major human rights that are important to you? You would probably say freedom of speech, freedom of assembly, freedom of worship, trial by jury. But if I go to the 35 countries in Africa where the Carter Center is involved and ask them, what is the basic human right that you feel most precious? They would say, we would like to live in peace. And we would like to have a decent home in which to live.
For some Illinois college students, despite a generational gap, Carter's words and efforts still ring true today.
One thing that really jumped out at me from his speech was he gave some examples of the things he accomplished, and he said, without dropping a single bomb, without committing any act of violence, he'd accomplish these things. And I think that's such a great thing to take away from this. If you see how we've acted over the last decades, how much violence we've inflicted on other people with really no result, no positive result in the forms of peace at all, then that's a really good way to be thinking about this.
A former leader still leading towards the future. Now, in talking with several students here at today's event, they said that hearing Jimmy Carter's words and seeing his actions from the past could serve as a good motivation for current lawmakers and national leaders facing crises across the world that we still see today. Live in Jacksonville, Ed Cross for WAND News. All right.